What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel inspired by R&R. Today we're going to be doing a little bit different video today. It's going to be a DIY of how to change my wife's brakes on her car. Usually most car dealerships or repair shops charge hundreds of dollars in order to change your brakes. We're going to show you guys how to change your brakes on a 2006 Altima right here today for the free. Step one, order your parts. We recommend ordering from rockauto.com, and we only spent $25 for ceramic brake pads for both the front and the back. These are the tools you will need: a jack stand, a pinch bar, a ratchet, a four-way tire iron, as well as a jack. Take your four-way tire iron and break the tension on the lug nuts. Use the jack to lift up your car, then place your jack stand under your vehicle for added support. Remove all lug nuts and the hubcap from the tire, then remove the tire. Remove the top and bottom bolts that hold the brake pads in place. Remove the old brake pads. Insert your pinch bar to push your caliper piston back flush. Make sure it is flush and remove the pad from the other side. Here's a side-by-side comparison of what the old pads look like versus what the new pads look like. Ronya's weren't too worn at all, but we still changed them out. Take the new brake pads and place them where the old brake pads were on both sides. Lower the cover back down and insert and screw the top and bottom bolts back into place. Use a socket to help tighten and secure the screws. Replace your tire, hubcap, and lug nuts. Remove your jack stand from the car and lower your car back down. Double check your lug nuts to make sure they are tight. Pump your brakes about 5 times or until you feel the brake pressure increase. Okay, so the process for the rear end is pretty much the same. First, you're gonna jack the car up and place the jack stand under the car. Then, you should remove the lug nuts and the tire. Remove the 2 bolts. Now, you may have to let the jack down to clear this control arm here. The brake caliper should come off. Just place it over to the side. Now, remove the old brake pads and replace with the new ones. Helpful tip: the shiny piece of metal is called the indicator, and this one goes on the front. The one without the metal goes on the back. Replace the brake caliper and screw on the bolts for both the top and the bottom. Now put your tire back on, pump your brakes until the pedal is tight. Do a test drive and drive and reverse just to make sure everything is inserted correctly. And that's it. You are done. This has been the basic way that you install brakes on a car.
Well, this is going to conclude the video on how to change brakes on a car by yourself. Sorry, there's some bugs out here and I don't do bugs. But hopefully this helps somebody that didn't know how to change brakes on their car. And do you have anything else?
Yeah, so I did have the help of my dad, who basically taught me everything I know about, you know, fixing on cars, especially like the basics and everything. So that helped a lot. It's really not hard to do as long as you follow those instructions. Whenever you're starting to work on a car, be sure to research how hard the job is going to be. You don't want to get into a job that you're too far into and then you have to get your car towed to the dealership or to a car maintenance place. So be sure to do that research. Hope this video was helpful to you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe.
Yeah.
And until next time,
peace.